What up? We are back in subsistence. For you, anybody who doesn't want to watch that 3 hours of the live stream from last night, Friday night's live stream, I'm gonna try to edit it to make it, not as long. Pretty good chance that that won't happen. Whoa. That's not reading. That's weird. A couple of those arrows didn't seem to read. But anyways, it's just gonna take a lot of editing, and I just don't know if I want to dig into it. So, quick recap. I died. Look at this. This is nice. A trifecta. Just needed one more. I should go get that. I'm actually gonna go get that ammo crate first. Anyways, I died in the live stream. A bear chased me down this bridge, jumped that, and got me. I was able to retrieve all my stuff, which was okay. I got a little bored and attacked the hunters over. They retaliated with a little night raid. I added some, which I've never done yet, some roofing, as you can see right there, and I need to fix some pieces, but I did that to prevent the grenades from the hunters from getting to my base and doing a bunch more damage. I'm kind of hoping that'll keep the damage somewhat minimal. I did do a couple locked crate runs as well. Got some okay stuff. Neither were great. And I have another lockpick. I'm going to go do another lock crate run here in shortly. I'm also should go show you what we have as far as our ammo. If you're just joining, my goal here in the next, I don't know, however many episodes, I'm going to go try to see what happens when you take a base command unit from a hunter's base down to zero hit points from whatever the 15,000 hit points is. At the same time, trying to get my base updated for the now raiding hunters. The other thing I did on the other episode was I finally moved my flower bed from the path of the raiding hunters to right up here. Oh, they need some water. So let's go get them some of that here in a minute. I saw a ammo crate. I really need those. Perfect. So, did get a lot done. Thank you for everybody who joined and participated in the chat and all that stuff. Makes it fun. I'll try to do, if I can, one during the week and maybe one on the weekend. If people like it, I can start doing more or less or whatever. Just gonna be hard to edit those, so I'll figure something out. But yeah, it's hard not going after these hunters and just kind of sitting around and grinding for ammo. But it's what I have to do right now because I'm super low on gunpowder and ammo casing, but the gunpowder mainly from the grenades. And I'll actually go up there right now while I put this stuff away, and I have to go make a new storage crate as well. I'm getting a little full. So I should have the stuff to do that real quick. Need some rope. Let me do a fuel brick while I remember it. There we go. So yeah, moving that. Do I have? Yes, I do have my lockpick already. Perfect. I might also at some point here shortly build a new refrigerator. It's getting pretty full, both of them. But I might also go ahead and move those and do a smoker or smokehouse or, you know, my own kind of little rendition of a smokehouse out on the patio, or what was now a patio that's now becoming enclosed. So as you can see, this will help those grenades that the hunters throw from hopefully going back and falling on them, or just not doing as much damage, I should say, to my base. Oh, excuse me. Alright. Just want to make sure we don't get these to stick out. I couldn't tell you which way is the right way. I thought that when you did it the right way, it would not push through the wall. But it looks like they're all pushing through the wall again. Okay, cool. What I'm going to do actually is dump stuff for right now. Barely have enough to dump everything. Okay. I need to go though. I don't know if I have any matches in here if I let this run out. Not yet. Nice. I left the match. I'm keeping these running to try to build up my fertilizer to help with the making of the gunpowder. So what we have right now is 8 grenades, bunch of shotgun shells, definitely not enough, a bunch of rifle rounds. I forgot to put those 9mm. I have a decent amount of 9mm I'm just keeping on me because it's kind of become my gun of choice. So I did have some arrows, but those have been kind of those have been getting used up. So what I'm going to go do now is see if we can hunt up a locked crate. Seems to be the easiest way for me to get my ammo parts and not costing me a ton of time and resources. Nice, here we go. Really looking for potassium. And I'm ending up getting a ton of iron. But hopefully down the road when we get updates, we'll get more stuff to build and we'll be able to use all those extremely oversupplied resources we have. So Saturday night, so hopefully you guys have been watching March Madness if you like the basketball. I'm not even a college basketball fan, but something about college basketball in March is during the tournament's fun. It's almost like they can't have blowouts. Every game's got to kind of be close. But I'm looking, I need a West Virginia, cheering for West Virginia. And so far, so good. They're still alive. Love this tree. Alright, and we're getting close to 100 subscribers, so once we get there, we'll run another contest. Not sure what kind yet. Once we get there, I'll worry about it. Oh shoot. We got company. If you miss that, go back and rewind, because I'm not turning around right now. It's not worth it, but I got some rogue hunters finally. It's been a long time since I've seen them out. But there are some rogue hunters back there. Right where I was looking to go to get Lock Crate and see if there was another one. From the live stream, Smoke Eater was telling me that there's usually another lock crate not too far from where I was. Or where I go to get my other lock crate, so I was planning on going to get 2, but now it looks like I have company. Unfortunately, because I'm trying to save ammo, I'm really not interested in hunting down rogue hunters, and they just don't give enough loot. But I I'm going to probably keep somewhat attacking the other hunters up there, mainly for the... Oh, that's just a shadow. It's not too bad as far as getting your... getting a decent return if you have a good shot. During the live feed, I didn't, I think I probably ended up a little upside down because I had a bunch of bad shots. A lot of shots seem to have been missing. With probably 100% of those misses being my own fault. But usually I complain about it not being my fault. So we got double hunters over there, and of course they came because I was... Okay. I was talking about how I haven't seen rogue hunters in a while. So of course they had to appear and cut down my angle. They make it kind of rough there without that... with me, with that lockpick. The only problem is there's about four of them, usually. I'm trying to think if it's worth making a different 9mm and going up there and trying to take them on. I know what I forgot to do that I need to do is give those new flowers some water. So yeah, so the base that... I was trying to build my base to make it look good. Now it's kind of more... Oh yeah, my lights are on. I have a bunch of lights on. And now it's more becoming a... building the base out of need. No need to keep those hunters out now. So kind of got to adjust with the game and with the updates. So plans don't always work out how they... how I mean for them to. But yeah, I'm going to keep working on this roof and get this all covered up in here. It is still bad. Shoot. I thought I got all that stuff fixed up. So, you know, I don't mind the night raids by the hunters. Just kind of keep things interesting, in my opinion. Oh, I thought I had a one bullet, one rifle round. I'm going to keep trying to figure out ways to make it a little bit easier to see those hunters on those night raids. Here's a crate. So nice to see the, and see, I'm finding some nice perks with that roof. But nice to see the rogue hunters are back and about. Last time the hunters attacked me twice on a revenge kill, they came back and attacked me twice when I killed and raided them, but not this time. So far just do one attack. And I'm pretty sure if I go and kill those rogue hunters, as long as I just kill one, they'll move. So that might be a plan here later on, just because I really need that area to lock down those locked crates. That's going to be the easiest way to get the... get some of the ammo at least quicker. Although I don't mind the grind at all. So here's where I'm running into issues. Also full. But you eat so much. From the office when Michael Scott, when Jim's kid gets left in the car, and Jim leaves Michael at the gas station without his wallet, and he has to walk around. Pretty good show. You know what I forgot to check? Awesome. I really like not having to have a bunch of chests, so. That'll be helpful. And we'll see if we got enough potassium here in a minute to make some gunpowder, and then we'll turn that gunpowder, hopefully, into a grenade. Which should give us about number 8, I believe. So that's 40, so that'll be perfect. And if you missed the live feed, you kind of want to stay here and watch. If you watch, they stack up. If you don't watch, they'll go... One will bounce here. Next one will bounce here. Next one will bounce here. And the next one will bounce here. So if you do more than 4, you won't... Don't... 5, 6, 7, 8 will all disappear. So just a heads up, if you sit here and watch, they'll stack. So, just something to save you from losing a bunch of gunpowder, especially if you just go and make a bundle and you step away and they stack up, and next thing you know, you're... So, see... But if I stick around, that one will... stack up. So here we go, we got enough to make one more grenade. Should have some more iron somewhere, but just in case, I'll fire that up. Ooh, here we go. And then tonight I'll have to go through and reorganize all these. There's some... Here we go. But at live stream, I was just trying to get as much as I could done. Perfect. So I think that's number 8. Ooh. And you can also, as long as you keep some biofuel in your generator, in here, you can always put it back. So just make sure you keep it in there. Go drop this one off. And that, actually that's number 9. Hey, not bad. Now I'm going to do one more roof, just so you can kind of see what I'm trying to get at. If I can't do a roof. A little bit low on wood. Like usual. Yeah, it's one of these where you got to kind of stop just flying right at your door now and making sure... Making sure you don't have any hunters in the process of coming to raid you. See, I've only been having 2 hunters come in the raids. The last 3 raids have only been 2 hunters. Yeah, there's usually 3 hunters at the base. Ooh, I forgot I needed to do some... Really needed some arrows. I'm trying to make bullets and ammo, so I hate wasting them. See which way he'll go. Of course. Okay, so here's what I'm trying to get at with the roof piece here. So in a couple episodes ago, when the hunters raided me, they nailed a couple grenades right in this little hole, and it did some pretty good damage. So now I'm gonna add this roof piece here. This one, of course, is a pain in the neck because of the solar panel. Ooh, might have had it there for a sec. There we go. So now I'm adding this so it covers that hole. Not only that, I'm kind of hoping if they don't get a good throw on it, the slant will help roll that grenade back down by the hunters or on the hunters would be even better. So that's kind of the plan around the roof. You know, none of this was all planned before until they had the raiding hunters. And if you haven't watched my other videos, this is kind of a little walkway because when those hunters come, you can't see their heads, and especially now when I've added this roof. But you still could hardly see their heads over this wall. So now if you go up to the top, you can get up on those planks and have some good... You can see their heads good enough to get some pretty accurate headshots. But that's what kind of makes the raids nice is, you know, they're... If you build that wall around the outside, they're pretty much lined up to where you can pick them off. Get some good headshots and pick them off. Alright, he moved. So hopefully I can get this and run. Nice. Nice, nice. So that's kind of my plan. If anybody else has any suggestions or ideas of what to do, let me know. But for right now, that's kind of my plan. I kind of am hoping that the... Oh, he's that way. By the time I actually get all the ammo and everything I would need to go destroy the VCU, he would have made an update. Because I don't think the VCU, when I destroy, it's going to actually do anything. I think it's just going to show zero and just sit there. I think the hunters will just build back up. But maybe by the time I actually collect enough ammo to do it all, he'll have added it maybe where... I'm kind of hoping he'll add it to where if you can actually destroy the base command unit, then the hunters will rebuild somewhere. So that way, if you don't like where a hunter has built, it takes a lot of resources to get them to move, but then there's still an option to get them to move. Yeah, I heard something, and that trap shooter guy is over there. I mean, the best shooter in subsistence history lives over there. He is amazing. So yeah, I'm on the lookout for ammo crates. That's a big priority moving forward to help get this done. And yeah, if anybody else has any other good ideas, I had some great ideas during the live stream. I did not even know, and so I'm going to tell people now. I believe it was Carol Lee that let us know, but I found a locked crate, and I think it ended up giving me 17 protein bars. And the funny thing was, I was complaining most of the time about how I had so many protein bars to begin with, and then I got a locked crate with 17 protein bars. But I didn't even realize I could use the protein bars to feed the chickens and the rabbits. So that is actually going to be my new food for them. I got to be careful about those rogues. So that's going to be my new food for the chickens. Of course, ammo crate right there. Is that the lock crate, though? If that's a lock crate, I will definitely go risk it. Doesn't look like it. God, there's two crates there. And the crate there. Alright. Sorry if I'm quiet here. Just listening for hunters. Don't know how I'm getting this lucky. There it goes. Alright, now we're just going to try to have him chase me all the way back to the base. Just not... One, I don't have that room anymore, as you saw earlier, and I'm trying to save that ammo. So don't forget, if you're new to the game or or whatever, as long as you have full stamina, which is right there on the bottom right, you can outrun these animals. You know, as long, I think a full stamina bar will get you there. But they'll eventually tire out and stop. And also go back and look if you're new. You can one-shot the wolves with a shotgun. I think I have it labeled as a one-shot shotgun video or whatever. You can Google YouTube. I'm sure people have them all over. But you just kind of crouch down and shoot him right in the jaw. Man, I sure wish I had a scope. Be fun to pick off those hunters. So, you know, there's a lot of different things you can do if you're trying to either A, avoid the animals, or trying to limit your resources. And if you're good with the bow and arrow, you know, you can collect them that way. That's why I have this here, is I can shoot down onto the animals from that bridge. Usually, last episode, that bear actually jumped on the bridge and took me down. It was definitely fun. Oh, that's a I mean, this sun's so nice here. Grab a screenshot of that. So yeah, so I think that's going to be the end of the episode. Well, for the next episode, what do I have planned? I'm going to work on the roof more. I am going to probably attack those rogue hunters, which will be a first for me. I have killed them, but I've never really gone after them. I ran into one and killed it by accident and got attacked by about three others of them and killed right up there. Probably one or two episodes after the Rogue Hunter update. That was their first spot to build, was right next to me. And so yeah, so thanks for watching, and hopefully I'll have that 3-hour long live stream one edited down to something a little more manageable. If not, you know, hopefully I gave you a good enough recap, and thank you guys for watching. Take it easy.